Hi everyone, this is the November 2012 monthly visions, supercharged expanded awareness. Funnily enough, I used to always put out my monthly visions around the first, second, third of every month. And the last few months, as you may have noticed, they keep getting later and later. And I was looking at my diary and I realized that they seem to coincide with the new moon every month now. So that just seems to be happening naturally. So this is coming out now with today, tomorrow's new moon solar eclipse, depending when you get to see this. So yeah, maybe that's just the way forward from now on. I think naturally they're wanting to come out at the new moon every month. So, you know, really appropriate seeing as now we're moving into the time of moving into our natural cycles. So 2013 onward, I think it will be a new moon monthly visions. So this month, we're going to be seeing the continuing acceleration with increasing intensity of that which we've been witnessing and experiencing all year, which has been extremes of actions, of emotions, of responses and revelations. The higher frequency energy that's flooding our planet right now and flooding our very cells is triggering and bringing to the surface everything within us that is in alignment with that energy. It's also bringing up everything within us that is not in alignment with that energy. So regards to bringing up that which is in alignment with our energy, we're seeing increasing numbers of people experiencing a sense of increased community, a greater sense of community, a greater desire for peace and unity, a greater need for fulfilling relationships and meaningful work, and a greater drive for truth, for justice, for fairness, for equality. We're seeing people, you know, just really get out there and speak up and just say, I've had enough of this or that, and just declaring what we want as a society. It's also bringing to the surface, as I said, everything that's not in alignment with this energy. So we're seeing this with flare-ups of old feelings that we thought we'd dealt with. And we're also seeing in ourselves the inability to tolerate situations that we would have accepted in the past. We're seeing major upheavals in our social, religious and political systems, and the cornerstones on which they were built that have been holding them together just no longer have the energy available to support them. So if you can imagine high frequency energy coming into the planet, completely overriding the old lower vibrational frequency energy. So everything that old lower vibrational frequency was holding up, as it's no longer available on our planet, those systems and structures of the foundation stones that have been holding up our old social, religious, political institutions just don't have anywhere left to be standing on. So for a lot of you who are despairing that things will never change, they are changing, they're going to change, they have to change. In the same way, as I've said before, when you move up to a digital frequency with your television and there's no more analog, it's not like, oh, what if some people just stick to analog, or what if some people don't want to let go of analog? Bad luck. If there's no more analog frequency energy available, you're staring at a static television, basically. There is no channels left to view on that frequency. So too with our systems and our structures. We're also seeing individuals and groups with a lot of resistance to this shift. Some of these folks are moving forward kicking and screaming, feeling very angry about the changes that are happening. They're seeing it as an attack and a threat on everything that they believe to be right. They're actually, through their lens of perspective, looking at everyone who's moving forward and evolving as crazy, literally. And yet you can hear this. You can hear this in political arguments. You can hear this on the media. People are just reacting in a really, really extreme way, one way or the other. Others are unable to move forward or change, as inwardly they are being guided to do, but due to strong fears, they feel unable to do so. So at the same time, it's impossible to stay in the old energies. So what's happening to many, as they can't move forward, but you know, we can't go back or stay in the old energies, they're experiencing a certain sense of frozen stuckness, which is manifesting sometimes as a depression, which is sometimes manifesting as quite full-on physical health issues. That is a manifestation of that frozen stuckness. So, you know, if you're experiencing this, you know, actually, if you're watching this, it's probably not likely that you're experiencing this to a full on level. But if you are, all I can recommend is doing as much as you can to move through your fears, move through your issues in whatever way it works for you, whether that's getting out in nature, whether that's journaling, whether that's meditation, whether that's seeing a healing practitioner to help you deal with whatever is coming up, whatever fears and old issues are coming up. If it is happening to the people around you, certainly if they're asking for help and support, absolutely guide them in the best way that you know how. However, what you may be finding is that they are not asking for help and support and are resistant to help and support and actually can't hear you or don't want to hear you or are just not even in your space or are moving out of your life. So for those people, it's a little bit like oil and water. The two are not mixing at the moment. So love and respect other people enough to know that they're going through their own process in their own way. If people are open for help, guidance, support, wonderful. If they are not in that space, let them be to experience their own evolutionary process in their own way, in their own time. Now, our next chapter is about us moving forward as conscious, awake, and aware beings who are truly free and empowered to creatively co-create our world. And all of these things are incredibly linked. You have to be conscious, awake, and aware, really, to be totally free, to be totally empowered, in order to be able to consciously, creatively co-create anything, whether it's your personal reality, the community reality, our national, global, collective reality. So all of that is happening right now. As we move forward into the next chapter of our human evolution, we're experiencing a quantum leap of expanded awareness, as so much that we have been unaware of is now coming into our conscious awareness. What's happening also is more of our higher self, that part of us that holds a higher state of vibration and consciousness, is currently in a process of descension. Descending into our physical bodies so that we are more and more becoming living embodiments of who we are on that higher level. There has been so much focus on ascension as our physical world moves up into a higher vibration, and I think a lot of people sort of have different you know, perspectives on what that means, you know, whether we float up into the sky or whatever, but it's not. It's that the earth herself and all everything and everyone on that earth is shifting up into the higher frequency with her. But at the same time that that's happening, this process of descension is happening simultaneously as our higher consciousness grounds and anchors itself into our physical bodies and into our physical reality, into our physical world, into our physical earth. Now, the fact that this higher consciousness is of a higher vibrational frequency to what we have been used to can't be overstated, and that is why it is so important to clear out our old stuff. You know, we have to sort of think a little bit like electricians or scientists at the moment, because it's a really similar process. And I'll explain that in a little bit. But this is why we've all been receiving the same inner message for years and years and years, to wake up, to deal with our issues, to clean up our stuff, to change our thoughts, change our patterns. And for those who haven't, it's like putting a high voltage appliance into a low voltage socket. The appliance will short circuit or blow a fuse. And we're seeing this happen in people physically and emotionally in various ways. Old paradigms, old ways of thinking, old ways of acting are literally self-combusting and imploding. And I'm sure that all of you are seeing that not only in your own personal lives, but in the people around you, and if you watch it on the news, and you know, when you hear about what's going on in your country, around the world, it's happening in that way. Now, this expanded awareness is giving us light bulb moment after light bulb moment, giving us more pieces of the jigsaw as to what exactly and how it's happening, what is contributing to the creation of our reality on all levels, personal level, family level, community level, country and global level. This expanded awareness includes everything from gaining major insight into our inner beliefs, in our patterns, our cellular stories. I encourage everyone to learn more about epigenetics, which is a scientific field of study now, relatively new. You know, it's been around for quite some years, but relatively new, which is actually showing that our cells carry the memory and thus beliefs of our parents, grandparents, great-grandparents. So if they went through something, let's just say they went through the Depression, our cells think that we did. And so some of our scarcity or lack issues, fear of survival, for example, can actually come from holding the cellular memory of our ancestors. So sometimes, you know, we're trying to dig left, right and center to see where our issues come from, and it's way back there in the past. So you don't always have to dig. Sometimes you can just ask, anything that is not mine, please be released. Anything that is no longer serving me, please be released. Or something I say, I'm aligned with my best possible self, my best possible reality, my best possible movement forward on all levels. I go through them all, physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, cellular, DNA, ancestral, etheric, and all the chakras. I say that every day. I encourage you to say something or do something similar that works for you. You know, we maintain our car every day. Well, not every day, but you know, we look after our car, we have a shower every day, we brush our teeth. We should be doing something similar to our energy bodies, because our energy is creating our reality. Can't say that strongly enough. Your energy bodies are creating your reality. Your physical body, your physical reality, that's just the result of the contents of your energy fields and what they are creating for you. This expanded awareness is not just happening on a personal level, it's also expanding and extending to the social. So we're going to be finding out, and are right now today, more of the truth about political and intelligence agency cover-ups. We're finding out a lot about the child sexual abuse cover-ups that are going on all over the world in areas of society where people have placed a lot of their trust, and we're finding out a lot more about that, and that will continue. We're finding out more and more about corporate wrongdoings and what those in positions of power really believe and say behind closed doors. So basically, those doors are no longer closed thanks to sneaky camera phones and very quick uploading on YouTube by people. So, and you know, may I remind you, the word apocalypse comes from the Latin and Greek, that which was hidden to be revealed. So the veils are opening, and we're seeing the little, you know, Wizard of Oz behind the curtain, and seeing what that little man is actually really like, or woman as the case may be. So we're finding out so much on a daily basis about the power games that are being played by those who put their own agendas ahead of the needs and rights of other people. It's said that Earth is a planet of free will. I think that sounds like a lovely playground idea, but it's time to grow up and step into our next level of consciousness and realize a couple of things about this whole free will situation. I'm sort of calling bogus on the whole free will situation, in that we have not had true free will on this planet. And many on Earth have completely abused the amount that we've been given. Free will, in its definition, is the freedom to do what you want without restraints. Yet we have had plenty of restraints on us. Yep, we chose it, it's all for a reason, blah, 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 whatever. The fact is, we've had restraints on us. So we've been limited. We've been limited from knowing and embodying the bulk of who we really are, where we're really from, why we're really here, and the abilities that we all have the potential to access. What we all really know on a higher level, on a higher level of awareness, has been hidden from us all of our lives. And it's been incredibly restrictive to have had to live our lives oblivious to the fact that our lives are how they are predominantly because of non-physical aspects of ourselves that we were never taught to look at or acknowledge. This stuff is not taught to us, has not been taught to us in schools, is not acknowledged by the media. Anyone who has gone there has basically been, you know, pretty much ignored, or, you know, told they're a bit crazy, or it's all been chucked in the self-help section. But you know, the people, the elite sort of level of people, certainly know all of this information. So the time is coming now that this information is going to be absolutely flooding throughout our mainstream, far, far beyond just self-help books and seminars and that sort of thing. I'm not sure actually what specifically is going to happen in terms of an event. I know a lot of people are waiting for an event. You know, I think we're all waiting for the big mystery of what, how, when that may or may not happen, but certainly enough light and high frequency energy is already coming onto the planet where that is absolutely happening already without it being a specific one day event. Now, in terms of, you know, this free will thing again, I put it to you, if we have 10 potential doors in front of us, but we've only been aware of 3 of those doors, is that really free will? You know, if we've had the free will to choose from those 3 doors, you know, I don't actually think so. I'm excited, and I know a lot of you are as well, about the fact that we are going to be, you know, made aware now of more doors. You know, we're going to be made aware of those 10 doors. Yeah, there's probably 100 doors, but you know, if we've been coming from 3, hey, let's go to 10 and even more. So it's really exciting. What is happening now is we're at this doorway of the beginning of the new cycle. Most people, you know, are innocently living their lives, doing the best job they can, you know, to raise their families, be good citizens, oblivious to the fact, you know, through no fault of our own, that a bunch of shady characters are running the world as they see fit, polluting the earth, corrupting the political and financial systems, creating a war here and there for personal profit and gain, participating as players in all sorts of toxins and injustices and abuses galore, all the while keeping hidden knowledge and resources to themselves that could help humanity and humanitarian crises in a flash. I really recommend the movie Thrive, also the Zeitgeist movies, good sources of information as well. Get yourself informed. This is not, you know, a Hollywood movie idea. This is not science fiction. This is not conspiracy theory. It's our world. And you know, when you face something, when you realize something, then you can actually start to live more consciously. They say, you know, truth is power, and that is so true, because when you know the truth, you can do different, you can choose different, you can be more free, basically, to make conscious choices. Thankfully, the time allocated to these shady characters for their way of doing things is over. And, you know, for the spiritually, politically correct folks, yes, we learned a lot with all of these restraints. Yes, we chose it all. Yes, I know we're all one big happy family and we're all going to have a cup of tea on the other side and say, wow, playing that shady character because that motivated all of us to change the world and create something new because you took us so far in the opposite direction. So, yay. But, you know, enough of that story. Thanks very much for your job, shady characters, but yeah, time for them to exit the stage, because it's time for a new play, it's time for a new scene, time for new props, time for a new world, time for new ways of doing things. Now, our expanded awareness will be such a turning point in our evolution, and the big truck is turning right now, okay? An increase in consciousness is not about just being zen and blissed out and sitting around meditating. It's not separate to our real lives, you know, physical lives. Our expanded awareness, our new level of consciousness is, you know, opening us up to what is our more real lives, to what is our destined reality. You know, the zen and the blissed out stuff, yeah, lovely bonus, you know, that is how it will feel and does feel even now sometimes more of the time than certainly it did, you know, 5-10 years ago. But mainly, you know, this expanded awareness is about living life awake and aware, knowing what's truly going on within us and around us. It's knowing what factors are contributing to the reality that we're living in. It is about using that expanded awareness to consciously create our reality. Our quantum leap in consciousness will thus be, and already is for many, a very grounding experience for those who choose to use this leap in grounded, practical ways to create new lifestyles, new ways of building homes, new media intentions, new ways of working with our health, ways of governing, new education models, and so on. Now, between the old time and the new time is the transition time, and we're in that right now. So the transition time is the time when everything that has been hidden is revealed. It has to be revealed in the same way that everything under a carpet is, of course, revealed when you go into a room to redecorate. So just like any under the carpet, what you see and discover is not always pretty, but thank goodness you looked, because now you can sweep it away and have a clean, shiny floor. So our new chapter will be built on new foundations of truth, greater consciousness, and higher awareness, with respect for all living beings, including our planet, being a priority. Revelations and revolutions are happening now in so many ways. People are currently living through the aftermath of Superstorm Sandy. Our thoughts and prayers are with all those affected in the Caribbean and the US. The days and the weeks and the months ahead are going to reveal many holes in the way that our authorities deal with humanitarian crises. Of course, these holes, you know, have existed in previous situations, but the difference now is that so many more people are going to be aware of them in a conscious way and will vocally call for those responsible to be held accountable or change to respect the needs of the people. Now, the United States just re-elected President Obama, which surprised many given the concern about the economy, but it was not surprising to anyone who is aware which way the vibrational wind is blowing these days. Now, while many are disappointed in Obama's perceived performance over the last 4 years, a shift to the alternative would have been a shift to beliefs, policies, and mentalities that are of the old world and belong in the old world. Now, this doesn't mean that there's been a resounding endorsement of President Obama. While the majority prefer him to the alternative, they're being very clear that the next 4 years need to be different, that inspirational speeches are no longer enough. Now, while it's clear to most that in order to get into a position of power like that, you have to play the game, the people are being very vocal and saying, we have had enough of the game. In my monthly visions, I included this quote that I really loved. It's from an interview with Jesse, the Mind Ventura, called Politics, Porsches and Paddleboards by Kenneth Raposa. It's on Forbes.com. And he says, Jesse says, I think every politician should wear a NASCAR race suit at this point. And Kenneth asks him, why is that? Jesse Ventura says, you know how the NASCAR race suits all have the ads stitched on them from the driver's sponsors? Politicians should wear that too, so we can see who owns them. And that's where we're at right now. You know, we're aware of how the political game runs, and quite frankly, I think everyone's really sickened by it. This election was not so much about the election of a new president. It was about people coming together to declare what they wanted and what they did not want. We're entering the era of the heart, and so the election really came down to which candidate most resonated with the people on a heart level. If the current president, in conjunction with his government, doesn't act in alignment with the trust that people have placed in him, if the political machine insists on continuing to play the game, we will see outright social anarchy and rebellion to overthrow the entire system, because this is not business as usual time. Everything not in alignment with the higher frequency we are entering has to transform or it will collapse, and that's just the way it is. Now, many of you might be saying the heart won't fix our economy or create jobs. Okay, fair call if you're, you know, struggling, people are homeless, losing their jobs, etc. Now, this will be hard to hear, but certain aspects of the economy are not meant to be fixed, and they are broken because they were built on a corrupt foundation. So we can't band-aid it up and just, you know, hope that it all goes away. certain jobs and industries are not meant to continue. This shift is not a spiritual concept. As I said, it's not about us all, more of us meditating. It is a real physical process that is facilitating transformation on every level. We will eventually see a new economic system emerge. We will see new jobs and fields of work develop. But the fact of the matter is that we are in the transition time, and this time was always going to be bumpy. No president or prime minister or person is able to avoid the turbulent waters that we're in. However, there is a vast difference in outcome depending on how they and we choose to navigate the ship. Now, a heart-based perspective and a heart-based approach will provide a more easeful passage in the current energetic climate, even if a mind-based logical perspective would seemingly make more sense in the current economic climate. In the old reality, people have the attitude that I use the present tense instead of had the attitude. It's not so much that it's linear. It's not like the old reality was then and the new reality is now and future. The realities are temporarily overlapping, less and less so, but there are some people who are literally still living the old reality now, some people living in the new reality already, and the majority living somewhere in between, crossing over in the transition time. So, yeah, in the old reality, people have the attitude that as long as the economy is okay, everything's okay, even if it actually only benefits the few at the expense of the many. In the old reality, our hearts were constricted somewhat. Our souls were driven by fear. So that created our what's best for me mentality. In the new reality, our hearts are opening. Our souls are yearning for love and connection. We strive for a what's best for us all solution and solutions to everything. We're discovering that a healthy economy on the surface doesn't mean anything if it's covering a multitude of corruption underneath. This corruption has to end. Politicians and business employers have to have new ways of working and new ways of treating their fellow people. They have to if they want to survive, if they want to continue. So in this way, the heart will create a new economy and it will create new jobs. This month, we'll be blessed by three major alignments. We've got the November 13-14 solar eclipse, depending where in the world you are. We've got the November 19 Pleiades alignment, and we've got the November 27 lunar eclipse. Now, this series, the way I'm being shown it, it reminds me of the process that happens when you're driving through the car wash. So it's like the soap is squirted on, then the water comes at you from every angle, and the automatic washers start pummeling your vehicle. And you can't leave halfway through if you've ever sat in one of those things, if you get a little bit scared. You know, I remember when I was little, I think I got really scared of that car wash. You sort of closed in there, the doors are shut. You know, you signed up for the whole deal. So you have to just sit there while your car gets a good wash and rinse. And then comes the hot air and the dryers, and they're all, you know, making it all nice and shiny, removing all the wet drops. You wait for the green light and then off you go into December. You know, so that's sort of the process that's happening in November, and we're going to be emerging into December cleaner, clearer, sparklier versions of ourselves. And more about December, obviously, in December. So that is all for now. Have a great month, and thanks for tuning in.